Hi everyone, this is Miriam. Welcome to my channel. I hope that you are doing okay. This video is completely unedited. Like, basically, I have some issues with my laptop and I can't publish videos and I can't edit. So you guys should pray for my laptop. So I thought, why should I limit myself? Let me just take my phone and make the video, and then I will upload it on YouTube naturally and directly. So that's basically why I'm here. So this is a video, this is a topic that I wanted to make, that I wanted to talk about for a while, and I'm really glad to finally be able to make a video. And I wanted to make a video about this since probably last year, but I finally, you know, I don't even know why it didn't happen, but it's a very important topic that I really want to talk about. You know what? Forgive my voice, forgive maybe my appearance today. The very truth is that I did not get much sleep. So I'm a bit exhausted, but I thought I would make a video on this subject because it's very important to me. Sorry for the lighting as well, I'm filming with my phone, but I hope that you guys get the message. Okay, so today I want to make a video about basically being okay with who you are as a person, whether being okay with your personality, loving your personality in terms of accepting who you are, including your personality, and that you don't have to change your personality because you become a Christian. This is important to me because if you look at the church community, or if you look at even society in terms of what is considered, in terms of who is considered nice and who is considered friendly, it all kind of has to do with maybe a type of personality. Is those type of people that are considered friendly, but if you are that way, then you are not easily approachable, so you don't fit the nice stereotype, or you don't fit the Christian stereotype. But what I want to talk about today, what I want to tell you, is that no matter what your personality is, whether you're loud, whether you're quiet, whether you're introverted, naturally extroverted, just know that God has no limit. God can use you no matter what your personality is. If you're a bit of an introverted type, God can use you. If you're loud and energetic, God can use you. And sometimes in the Christian community, in the church community, in terms of, you know, as we gather with other believers, sometimes it's as if there are people that, it's as if basically people think that Christianity is a type, that if you're a Christian, you have to be, you know, quiet and wear long skirts and just be like, hello, hello, hi, hi, hello, 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 I'm so quiet. But this is not true. Christianity is not a type of personality. Christianity is not a personality. Christianity is basically, once you become a Christian, in terms of when you actually develop a relationship with God, there's a difference between being a Christian and actually having a relationship with God, a personal relationship with God, like loving God and loving His presence, you know. When you actually become a Christian, loving His presence, you know. So when you become a Christian, like proper, like have a relationship with God, not just Christian, you realize that, you know, obviously, you start loving people the way God loves them. You start seeing things through God's lens. So it's a thing where you don't let go of your extroverted, energetic personality or your quiet demeanor, but you basically just start seeing things God sees. Start loving people the way God loves them. Start seeing people the way God sees them. If you were someone who, you know, you don't like people, when you become a Christian, you realize that, oh, people are made in the image of God. So you start loving people, you start approaching people. So it's not that you let go of your personality, of your happy-go-lucky personality. It's just that God starts influencing you from the inside out, and you start being the person that God wants you to be. But it does not mean in any way that Christianity is a personality. And sometimes that's what we get in the Christian community, you know, that, you know, in my, for example, in my church, yeah, in my church, in terms of in London, in the UK, I love my church, and that's basically where the inspiration for this video came from. My leader there celebrated every personality, whatever your personality. Like, he knew that God can use everybody. God does not look at, oh, like, you don't look like a leader, you don't look like, you know, you're too quiet, so God cannot, like, I cannot use you. God does not look at the personality. He looks at your willingness. He looks at your heart. So never let the fact that you're a certain way, or you don't like certain things, or you're a bit more quiet, or you're a bit more loud, don't let that limit you. Don't think that God cannot use you because you don't fit the Christian, nice, quiet persona. Christianity is not a personality. God can use your energy for his kingdom. He can use your quietness for his kingdom. That's the only problem happens when, you know, basically the thing is, what I want to say is, it's only when you start developing a relationship with God that is a thing where you don't let go of your personality, but God gives you wisdom in terms of how to react in certain situations. If you're someone who is quite extroverted, who is quiet, you know, you meet people like this from a mile away, you can see them, their energy just flows. As soon as they come into a room, you just feel their energy. They're just so... There are people like this. I have friends like that, and it's just lovely to be around them. But it's a thing where when you become a Christian, it's a thing where God gives you a bit more wisdom. So he teaches you to mourn with those who mourn, to cry with those who cry. If there's someone who is sad, he's gonna, you know, God will tell you, hey, Miriam, or, you know, whoever you are, calm down. You have to mourn. You have to comfort this person who is crying. You shouldn't be like that at that moment in time. Or if you're someone who's a bit more introverted, you know, and you are put in a position of influence, whether it's in your work or wherever you are, you have influence, whether you believe it or not, whether you're, you know, a leader that people see or not, you have influence. People watch you in everything that you do. So God teaches you that, hey, I know that you're a bit more introvert. I know that you're introverted and you're a bit more quiet, but now that I live in you, now that, you know, you live for me, you have to be able to approach people, you know, approach those who are sad, approach those who are happy. You have to be able to say hello to people. You have to let go of your comfort zone and let go a little bit of your, I just like to be on my own, and go to people. So God starts influencing you in terms of, he starts putting his characteristics in you to become better. So it does not mean that if you're someone who lacks happiness and who likes to be happy, because you're a Christian now you have to just be dull. Or it does not mean that because, you know, you're a bit of an introverted type and you lack your own space, that you know, suddenly God cannot use you. But he will just teach you to go to people a bit more, and to, you know, let go of your comfort zone a bit more. But yeah, whatever your personality is, God can definitely use you. And as I said, in my previous church in the UK, my leader celebrated every personality, and I loved it. He did not limit anyone. He did not say, oh, because you are this type, Miriam is this type, so she cannot do that. He looked, basically, God looks at the heart, and a real leader, a real friend, will look at your heart. He will not look at how you are and say, no, you can't do that because you are this certain type. But he will look at your heart. He will look at your servitude, how you serve. That's what's important. So I used to have a hard time with this because what is my personality? If a good friend of mine described me and said that Miriam is the kind of person who will speak when she needs to speak, and he will not speak when she does not need to speak. So that's basically my personality. The thing is, without people, if I don't speak to people, and if I stay in my room all the time and I don't communicate with people, I would feel empty, because I'm the kind of person who loves conversation, who loves to talk to people. But at the same time, I also like to be on my own sometimes, and I like to be calm. So it depends on the situation, but I'm not extroverted and I'm not extra introverted either. And I had a hard time with this before, because I would look at other people and I'd be like, why am I not like this? Like, why am I not like, I'm going crazy? Why am I not like this? Why am I not, you know, this type? And I had a hard time. And I remember when I was in youth conference in 2009, I was at a youth conference in the UK. And I remember just looking at the girls and how, you know, they were just so like, hey, you know, and me, I'm not like that. Like, I'm not really like, hey. So I remember thinking, I don't like me because I'm not like them. So I will change who I am for a day and I will pretend to be loud and also rude because I don't like who I am and I want to see how it feels to be loud and rude and like this. So for a day at a youth conference, church youth conference, I changed for a day. I became someone who I was not in order to fit in or in order to be somebody else. So I basically faked my personality for a day. And because the girls that I was in the room with did not know me, so they did not know that I was basically pretending to be somebody else. And what happened is at the end of that day, I got in trouble. I got in a fight. And the youth leader at that time had to come and separate me. And I did not recognize myself. And after that, I realized that, Miriam, that was the stupidest idea you've ever had. That's the stupidest thing you've ever done. Don't change who you are in order to fit in. You know, don't change, don't pretend to be somebody else in order to fit in. It's okay to be who you are. It's okay to be, you know, a bit more observant. God can use you however you are. But the thing is, there's a difference between, for those who are a bit more like introverted, you know, people sometimes confuse quietness with timidity. There's a difference. Timidity is a thing where you're afraid of people. You're afraid to go to people because of rejection, or you're just a bit insecure, so you like to be in your own space, so you're timid, you don't want to go to people. That's timidity. Quietness is different. Quietness is a bit more like you're more introvert and you're more of an observant. You're more of an observer, someone who observes, than someone who speaks. That is quietness, it's not timidity, but there's a very thin line between quietness and timidity. But yeah, so no matter what your personality is, yeah, just love who you are. Just love who you are. Know that there's no limit. God can use everybody, and personality and Christianity is not a personality. We need loud people and energetic people in the Christian community to be hyper for God, to be joyful for God, to be energetic for God, to be energetic in their workplace, so that people will see that, oh, Christianity is actually not dull. And we need people who are a bit more observant, who are more in the reserve, because these people honestly make the best listeners. They listen. If you have a problem, they come to you, they counsel you, they advise you, because they listen. They have the gift of listening, you know. So whatever your personality, just know that God can use you. And as I said, as you become a Christian, as you become serious in your walk, of course, God will also put his personality, his likeness into you. So if you're more introverted, he will teach you to go to people a bit more because people need your input. If you're very loud, God will teach you to mourn with those who mourn and comfort those who are sad and not always be like, when people need a shoulder to cry on. So it's basically balance, but just know that whatever your personality type is, it's okay. Be loud, be happy, be energetic, be who you are. And don't, you know, there's no personality for kindness. There are people that are very energetic and very woo, but they are very kind. There are those who are very like quiet and observant and are very mean. You know, personality, kindness has nothing to do with personality. So be who you are. God can use you whatever your personality. That's what I want to say, and that's what I wish I was told when I was very, very young. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. This video is the rawest video I ever made. No makeup, just speaking, basically, with my heart. Anyway, I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. I will see you next time, and leave your comments. Tell me what you think of this video. Okay, bye!